My name is Marta Martín, and I'm going to present the paper A Perception Teacher Training Program about Video Games, Perception of Knowledge about PEGI, that is written by myself, Ana García Vargas Muñoz Repiso, and Azucena Hernández. Then, I'm going to structure my speech, taking into account the structure of the paper. Then, we have the introduction. Video games are one of the common ways of entertainment nowadays, not only for children, also for adults. We can play video games any time and any place. But video games are not only a way of entertainment, video games are can be used in education, taking into account that it's possible to improve different skills, abilities, or content. Then, it's important to take into account, oh my god. It's important to take into account when we want to implement video games in education different criteria, like for example a video game content system that is PEGI in Europe. Then, for that reason, we are going to analyze in this paper recently primary school teacher perception of knowledge about PEGI before and after a teacher training program for recently primary school teachers. Considering the complete sample, the participant gender, and peer training in video games as educational research. And also we are going to analyze if there were statistical significant differences in before and after the teacher training program. Then, firstly, video games are an increasingly common form of entertainment, but there is growing interest in the use of video games in education, resulting in a large amount of research in recent years, like for example also my PhD dissertation, then that it was 1 month ago. Okay, and video games, it's possible to implement video games to work different things, like for example, there are some benefits like student motivation, and another educational benefit, like for example, conceptual learning, the abilities and skill development, attitudinal change, and for example, self-esteem improvement, and the improve of the relationship between the students and the teacher. And also, when we implement video games in education, it's important to take into account different criteria, like for example, in Europe, the Pan-European Game Information System, that is a system that provides information to the users to make informed decisions about the games before using or before buying them. In other countries, there are another, like for example, SSARB, Entertainment Software Rating Board, and they consist in the descriptors to classify the suitability for video games for different age groups. And it's important to say that this kind of classification or rating system are not intended to indicate the difficulty or the abilities that the players need to play this game. It's related to content. And there are two types of levels, age level and also the PEGI content descriptor that are related to the content that are inside the game. Like for example, content related to drugs, content related to sex or violence, for example. Then, knowing about this kind of content is important to teachers because they need to know the games that are useful for the classroom and also to help their own students to select video games for their own use. Then, but the problem is that most teachers and users don't know about that because there are different studies that say that people don't know about that. Like for example, in Martín Basilio de García de Alcárcel, only 23% of students in the first year of the degree in pedagogy knew what PEGI was. And in other study, in Guerra and Revueltas, in terms of gamers, only 37% of gamers know about that. Then it's important to teach these kind of things, not only for using in education, but also for the entertainment. Then, it's important to say that we implement and design an asset, a teacher training program for pre-service primary school teachers about collaborative learning with video games. That is when we use video games in collaborative learning activities. It lasts 30 hours and it was never ending. And then, it was about four things, in which in one of these things we spoke about criteria to select video games, like for example pay. Then the four things of the Preserving Teacher Training Program was what video games are, the relationship between video games and education, the relationship between video games and collaborative learning, and the creation of video games by the students or by teachers. Then, in the third topic, the relationship between video games and collaborative learning, we spoke about the criteria to select video games for the classroom, and one of them was pay. Then we spoke about today about the pay aims, the utility, the places where we can look for information about that, like for example web pages, journal, or video game covers. Then we organized different activities to explain this topic. Like for example, the teacher explained the information. Another activity was the student review different covers of different video games to know about that, not only for children, but also for adults. And also, the students in the teacher training program need to design an educational proposal about how to use video games in collaborative learning activities. And for that objective, in order to do that, they need to analyze PEGI age levels, PEGI content descriptors, and other issues related to games, like for example the language, the game type, the game genre, and other educational aspects that, like for example, educational content, curricular content, and the methodological strategy to implement this video game. Then, in terms of our paper, today's paper, it's important to say that the methodology was program evaluation, a quasi-experimental minimal control design with a pretest and post-test with our only group. And this paper we are going to focus because there are another variables in the complete study, but in this case we are going to focus on the perception of knowledge about PEGI rating system in preserving primary school teachers. Because we think that it's important not to know if they think they know about that, because it's important that teachers have self-confidence in themselves. They need to believe in their own abilities and in their own knowledge about video games when implementing the video games in the classroom. Then, okay, we analyze this perception of knowledge before and after the teacher training program, taking into account, as we said previously, the complete sample, the participant gender, and if they have received previous training about video games as educational research. And if we want to know if there was statistical significant differences. Then we use a questionnaire, and the sample was 123 preserving primary school teachers from the University of Salamanca. And it's important to say that 23% were men and 76 were women, like in our university, because in our studies in degrees in education, most of our students are women. Then, and also it's important to say that men have a greater frequency of play, as it's important to take into account when we analyze the data after that. Then, the results. It's important to say that, firstly, few students know about that, but after the teacher training program, most of them know about that. And also, not only men, that maybe they know about that, more about that, but also women and men increase and improve their knowledge about that. And also, in terms of previous training, taking into account video games as educational research, both groups, people who have received training about that and people who have not received previous training about that, improve their knowledge or their perception of knowledge about that. And also, finally, we want to know if there was statistical significant differences between pre-test and post-test. And also, the findings show that it was a statistical significant differences between the pre-test and post-test in the complete sample for men, and also for individuals who have not received previous training about video games as educational research. Then we can say that the teacher training program increased the perception of knowledge About Peggy, among present primary school teacher planning, school teacher participants. And also, in terms of conclusion, we want to say that video game content racking system is important to know, it's a criteria to select video games to use in the classroom. Then, it's above all very important, we want to implement video games in early childhood education, in primary education or secondary education, because teachers need to be careful when implement video games in these stages because of the content of the video games. And also, when implement teacher training or teacher education related to video game, if this kind of content is needed to add in this kind of teacher training programs. And also, for that reason, in our teacher training program, we include between other contents, because we work on other things in our present teacher training program, it's important to include this kind of content. Then, as we previously said, few students knew about that previously, but after the program, most of them know about that. But then we can say that the teacher training program increases the student perception of knowledge about PEGI, but it's necessary to consider aspects like, for example, gender and previous training when developing this kind of teacher training programs, because maybe there are students that don't know about video games, or maybe there are students who don't play video games in their real life. Then, and the two limitations of our work, firstly, obviously, our results are based only on perception in this paper, and for that reason, we are working in other paper analyzing the results of the students, analyzing the educational proposal about video games and collaborative learning to know if they use appropriate video games taking into account PEGI content descriptor and PEGI age levels, and if they analyze in a correct way these video games. And also, it's important to say that the second limitation, the percentage is only 91%, not 100%. Then we know there is certainly room for improvement, and for that reason, in future implementation of the teacher training program, we want to label different video games taking into account of the criteria of PEGI, that the students label different video games for themselves, taking into account the different criteria that PEGI gives to the user to decide if they know what PEGI label is better or not. Then, finally, I want to say that, this research was made possible for a predoctoral grant for this university, and also finally the references.